Hi there, Nick here. Welcome to the first lesson in a series of 6 videos on how to connect Dialogflow with Landbot. This course is for everyone. It's for beginners that want to get started with Dialogflow, or for those experienced developers that want to know how to exactly set up the block and get started quickly with NLP inside Landbot. So in this first lesson, we'll see how to get started with the Dialogflow platform. First, we'll see how to create an agent. Secondly, what are intents and how to create one. And lastly, we'll test the agent inside the Dialogflow platform. So we will start by creating a Dialogflow agent step by step. First, log in into Dialogflow. If you don't have an account, you'll need to create one. This new account you create needs to have access to the Google Cloud, since Dialogflow is a platform by Google that uses their cloud. And just a quick side note, you might need to give the credit card details when creating the account in order to test the feature correctly. So once we've logged in, press on Create New Agent. A Dialogflow agent is a virtual agent that handles conversations with your end users using natural language processing, which means that it understands the nuances of human language and later translates it to structured data that Landbot understands. So when clicking on Create a New Agent, some settings will be presented. First, add an agent name. In this case, I'll call it Pizza Restaurant. Set up the language and time zone you're in. Google project and agent type are not required, so we'll leave them like they are. Press create. Once the agent is created, we'll be presented with this default view. As you can see, we're inside the tab intents. What an intent does is categorize an end user's intention and match it with one of your previously determined answers. To understand it better, let's check the different intents created by default. Let's start with the default welcome intent. Once inside, we'll have some training phrases. If we scroll down, some responses. And on the right side, the option to test the agent. Let's test the agent by typing hello. As you see below, the answer from the agent with other parameters is displayed. This test section will be really handy when you're building agents. To understand what is happening, when we type hello, the default welcome intent is triggered, and one of the responses is returned. That is the main logic and how Dialogflow works. Now, return to the intent section. Let's see what the default fallback intent does. In the test section, type in something like, what time is it? This is the result. As you can see, in Dialogflow, when no intent was triggered for a phrase like, what time is it? The default fallback intent will trigger, and one of the default responses will be displayed. Now, let's create a custom intent. Press on Create Intent. As intent name, I will type restaurant location. Now, we'll add some training phrases. Click on Add Training Phrases. To get started, add some phrases like, where are you located? What is the location of the restaurant? Please, can you tell me the address? What is the address? And where is the restaurant? As you can see, all the sentences have different ways to express the same goal, the same intent. Intents group different ways to say with natural language something that has the same goal. In this case, the goal, the intent, is to know the location of the restaurant. Dialogflow recommends having around 20 phrases per intent. The more the better. For now, we'll keep it like this, but you can always add and edit these phrases later. Now, for the responses, you can add one or more possible responses. If you have more than one, Dialogflow will randomly choose one to display. Okay, now it's time to test your new intent. Let's type something like, where is the restaurant? Great, now you have the response according to the intent you just created. Let's try something different, but with the same goal, like, where is your location? Great, the restaurant location intent is triggered. Oh, and one last thing. If you want to see what is actually happening and what Landbot will receive to later use in your bot, press on diagnostic info. So that's it for the first lesson. Tune into the next one, where we'll see how to get the JSON key file that will connect Landbot with a specific agent you have in your Dialogflow account. That's all for now, and I'll see you in the next one.